Despite being a new model of ship, the system you see here largely emulates that of the previous Courageous. Our operations manual only covers the bare minimum. Should you find anything lacking, you'll have to figure it out as you go.
Understood. I'll make sure to pass it on to everyone else.
In total, it spans a length of 92 Arge, a considerable step up from the previous 74 Arge class. However, because the ship is so much bigger, you'll need to carefully watch the speed and engine output.
Ha! So she's a wild one, eh? Sounds to me like this girl's gonna need a bit more taming than the last one.
This terminal should give you complete command over all the ship's facilities and fire control systems. It comes equipped with anti-hacking measures, specially developed by Professors Albert and Erica Russell themselves.
You mean Mom and Grandpa made it? We should have no problems then.
Incredible. Every inch of equipment on this ship is state-of-the-art.
And that computer's one of the Epstein Foundation's next-generation models. Weren't they only just developed?
That's right. And its hull has the latest innovations in hydrodynamic engineering, courtesy of the Ruhr Institute of Technology. Plus, it seems to be outfitted with ZCF's newest next-gen orbital engine, too.
It only gets more and more unbelievable every time I hear it. Just how did you manage to construct a cutting-edge ship like this abroad in total secrecy, without anyone finding out?
As I stated earlier, there are a great deal of individuals who helped me make this happen. Such as Mr. Gwyn here, for instance.
The story here goes all the way back to right after the Civil War. Considering the way it ended, His Highness decided to approach me for some advice. He had me prepare this ship for him, all in anticipation of the day when the Crimson Wings would be torn from the sky.
So that's why.
Huh. I do remember His Highness mentioning something about you being his advisor.
This is...
I underestimated them. Shira, I'm sorry.
Sorry, Ayn. Looks like I messed up.
Goddess, please protect my daughter.
You have 15 seconds until the hull collapses. So before then, I will offer you one final wager. A gravitational barrier will appear on the bridge for exactly 24 seconds. Let's see if you can come back from this.
Adios, help us!
You gotta stay calm.
Get down and brace for impact. Over there! Damn! The gravitational barrier.
It's not gonna hold.
Don't give up just yet.
Was I a moment too late? Nay, surely a flicker of hope yet remains. Can you still be plucked from the jaws of Gehenna? Show me just how far that luck of yours will take you, my dearest rival.
those of you who have not yet had the honor, my name is Roselia Milstein. I am the elder of Erebonia's Hexen Clan. Emma and Vita are my disciples in the magical arts. It is a pleasure to finally meet you, Prince Olivert, as well as the storied children of Crossbell and Liberal.
Indeed, being sent forth by Adios, much like the holy beast of Earth. Thomas Lysander, Second Dominion of the Grawlsritter. Estelle, Lloyd, I've heard many a rumor about your respective endeavors. As for you, Your Highness, I don't think we've had the chance to talk since you were last at the main campus.
Thank you.
The solution is simple. Use this ship to whatever end you see fit. The rivalry of the Seven appears to be the true objective behind this plan of the Chancellor and the Gnomes. That much we can safely assume. And yet, it is this very same objective that may be our sole hope in preventing the disaster to come.
You for real here? It's true that ever since this curse was unleashed, it's felt as though everything's being guided by some unseen force. With that in mind, it'd be near impossible to try and prevent the war altogether.
That's probably why Dad and Chloe opted for Operation Meal Mirage instead. But while we're on it, what exactly is this curse anyway?
We know full well the sort of strife a Septarian can cause. We saw so ourselves during the incident in Labrul a few years back. There, we had to come face to face with the same issues our ancestors contended with 1,200 years ago.
It was the same for us. We fought back against a centuries-long plan to artificially recreate a Septarian. One that had been lost due to mankind's own hubris.
Yeah, I almost made a really big mistake back then. But then Lloyd and the others came and made everything all right again.
In Labrul, a ring that could grant any heart's desire. And in Crossbell, a tree that could rewrite destiny itself. Each one a blessing, yet each one a curse. But in spite of that, Estelle, Lloyd, and everyone else faced them head on. They didn't lose heart even once.
Therefore, discovering the truth is your responsibility now. It's not something Estelle, or Lloyd, or even the rest of us can accomplish. Only you, Class 7 of Thor's Military Academy.
The Empire's facing threats both on its surface and behind the scenes. You're no strangers to kicking tail on either of those fronts. I can't think of a more tenacious bunch out there. The way I see it, you guys are the only ones who can do this.
It's up to us, then.
Naturally, the Courageous Two has its own missions to see to. We must travel around the country helping people and gathering allies. Even so, I have no doubt that we can still serve as your wings of passage. More so with the Merkaba out of commission. After all, the difference in size should be more than enough to fit, say, 2 Divine Knights and 4 Panzer Soldats,
Olivert.
You've put so much thought into this. We appreciate it.
Then Thor's Military Academy's Class 7 would be honored to take you up on that offer, Your Highness. We'll do everything we can to assist you in your efforts as fellow members of the Radiant Wings.
We'll help too. It's only fair after all you've done for the branch campus students.
If you ever need someone to make that ship purr, I'm your gal.
Fabulous! Delighted to have you. You see, we've been rather lacking in the crew department.
Well, I sure as hell ain't sitting this one out. What kind of instructor would I be otherwise?
Count me in too. I mean, we're finally all back together again.
Like we said, we're gonna be off doing our own thing, but we'll still be helping out.
Same with us. We'll be catching a ride on the Bobcat 2 after we're done here.
Now that you mention it, you did both say you'd be working separately.
Yeah, the plan is to cover Eastern Erebonia, Northumbria, and Jirai.
You mentioned getting in touch with HQ and Laman. Guess that means you guys are heading out too, huh, Shara?
We are. Though we won't be leaving the ship until tomorrow.
Sarah, Fee, you guys got things covered here, yeah?
Of course. When have we ever let you down?
Call us if you need anything, okay?
I guess this is goodbye for now then, huh?
Yeah. We've got some stuff to take care of back in Crossbell.
Don't worry. We'll be seeing each other again before you know it. In the meantime, let's give this our all.
Yeah! We got this, Yuna!
Right!
just as glad as you to see him alive again. But feelings such as that are only for the weak. We're ending this world and creating a new order in its place. And an undertaking this great leaves me no room for weakness.
was just about to say the same. Reen, everyone, it puts my heart at ease to see you all in good health. At any rate, it sounds like you're becoming quite the lady killer, eh, Reen? So, any updates on your love life? Who's the lucky gal?
Wow. I've heard rumors about that luscious silver hair and jet black outfit, but... This character development has my pen bursting with inspiration!
Man, that edgy new look is just not fair.
You don't mind if I crank out a script for a new radio show based off you, right? Right?
It's been a wee while, but the time's finally come! Say hello to the Becky Association's Courageous Branch! Looking forward to your patronage troops!
I'll have to agree with you there. By the way, Rin, are you still keeping up with your fishing? I've been hearing about guardians appearing all over the place.
do is continue to move forward. I've been far too busy with my own preparations. Now hurry along inside. And, Celine, you may wish to steel yourself.
Yeah? What in the... Why am I...
I advised you to steel yourself for a reason. The Luna Sanctuary is a hallowed ground that unveils the truth. Indeed. The energies in this sacred realm allow me to assume my original form with ease. And perhaps, even my true form. In the depths of the shrine sits the Reflecting Pool, a holy relic maintained by wandering witches throughout the ages. Mirrored within it are the echoes of the Empire's hidden past, intertwined with the secrets held in the Imperial family's black records. It should show you everything, now that the great twilight is upon us. But before you can glimpse into the past, a trial awaits you.
It would appear you're finally starting to catch on. The reason I had to bid you farewell in the first place was so I could assist Grandmother with her preparations. As such, I will be serving as the opening act for your trial. Oh, and I've brought a guest performer. I do hope you like surprises.
This is not quite what I had in mind, but I will allow her to do as she wishes, so long as she fulfills her role. As for yours, aim for the deepest recesses of the shrine as if your lives depended on it, because that may, in fact, be just the case.
There you are. Are you ready to begin the show? I wonder, do you truly have what it takes to find the truth hidden among the shadows? To emerge victorious from the rivalries ahead? It's time we put you to the test.
I see you're still raring for a fight. But remember, you face the Golden Rock Shuffle, the warlord who leaves entire battlefields trampled in her wake. You will kneel before my blade.
So you've arrived at last. Well done.
Hello, Grandmother.
Is that the reflecting pool?
Yes. Though the proper name for it is the Spectral Moon Mirror.
Oh, the water's so crystal clear.
So this is what the Wandering Witches spent so many generations watching over.
Now I see. It's actually an artifact, isn't it?
For real?
It does emanate a certain aura, not unlike that of the Bell of Crossbell.
Very astute. That particular artifact was passed down through the Croyce family. It is but one of many. The tetracyclic towers of Liberal, the recluse cube of the Liberarch, the black records of the Arnor family, even Prince Oliver's sonorous seashell.
Legend says Adios bestowed artifacts to a number of different groups back in the days of yore.
Which would mean this mirror was the artifact consigned to the witches.
Correct. The Spectral Moon Mirror works in tandem with the Black Records, and is itself connected to the spirit shrines scattered about the land. It is also the source of the many visions you have experienced. Nevertheless, it is quite a rarity for its powers to manifest, even for us witches. But everything changed the moment we congregated together in this shrine. Emma, the wandering witch, and Celine, her familiar. Schmorzer, the cursed sacrifice, and I, the elder of the Hexen Clan. The great twilight is upon us, and a frenzied thirst for blood sweeps over the land.
So we're really doing this?
Red Moon Rose, the true ancestor of the vampires.
The term vampire is little more than slander. A myth that masks the reality of my kin. Although, when it comes to manipulating vitality, I suppose there is a hint of truth to the tales.
Holy beast. You're the origin of Grianos and myself.
Roselia was the name once borne by an ancient creature.
1200 years ago, it fused with the Kin of Fire's elder to prevent a great calamity of their time. This creature was the holy beast sent forth by the goddess, the Burning Sphinx.
Grandmother!
So you're the one the church has been searching for. The other holy beast, long thought to have disappeared.
Damn, who would have guessed?
As I have already stated, I am not the first to bear the name Roselia. The original disappeared 900 years ago, likely due to the gnome's betrayal. I began my existence as a familiar, not unlike Selene.
What?
My predecessor showed me this place, telling me to return here should anything happen to her. I obeyed, and when I arrived, the spectral moon mirror allowed me to inherit a part of her memories, as well as her mission. Thus did I become the second Roselia.
Come to think of it, that bird Vita used to own had azure wings just like those.
So both familiars were made in the image of the holy beast that created them.
Now I understand why you wanted Selene to come here.
Indeed. The great twilight is upon us, and our clash with the gnomes draws ever closer. Given the state of the world and the coming of the rivalries, nothing is guaranteed. As such, should the worst come to pass, Selene is to serve as my successor.
That would mean... Rose, just what are you planning to do?
Nothing so drastic as dying, I assure you. But we must account for every possibility. Filling the air with strife will cause the reflecting pool to show us visions linked to the Black Records. Having a wandering witch and the ultimate sacrifice here should allow us to see the truth of this curse in its entirety.
I see. We need to uncover the full vision. All the glimpses we saw in the other shrines were just pieces of it.
And in order to trigger it, we need to fight.
So we're really going to fight you, without holding anything back?
Precisely. Now, enough dawdling!
Whoa! What a formidable aura.
But we can't back down now.
Right. It's now or never.
Class sevens, new and old. It's time to face our greatest trial yet.
We'll prove the time Millium bought for us was not in vain.
We will fight to uncover the hidden truth. I've got a few choice words to say about all this, Rose. But I'll fight you first and complain later.
Then come, children. Face me with the full extent of your strength. We shall see how you fare against the Hexen Clan's elder. I, a holy beast of the goddess, Roselia, the Burning Sphinx!
Huh. How'd you like that, huh?
That was tough, but I think we did it.
I didn't expect you to be able to hold your ground so fiercely, children. Now I understand how Ragnar and must have felt after facing your kind.
Huh? I know of the ancient dragon, but the other name...
It sounds similar to that of the Steel Maiden's Divine Knight.
It is a name that has passed from this world into oblivion. But back to the matter at hand. You have all passed the trials set before you. As for what comes next, you had best brace yourselves.
The spectral moon mirror. It's...
I'll guide us through. Everyone get ready.
What is this?
The fragments of the past preserved in the Black Records.
a reality even I have yet to see. Do not avert your eyes. This is the truth.
Damn it! Why? How could the boss just leave us like this?
He told us to take care of Fee. He must have been prepared for this. The boss dragged Baldur the War God straight down to Gehenna with him. I'm sure he's happy about that. And yet...
What a shame. It would seem I failed to make it in time.
You.
Ain't you that guy from the workshop?
Why, yes. Oh, I do hope our S-weapons are serving you well. I have a certain proposal that you might find of interest. And as it so happens, everything we need to execute it can be found nearby. If all goes well, it may be possible to bring your boss back to life.
What was that?
Now you're just talking crazy.
Very well. I cannot fault your suspicion. Perhaps the Red Constellation would be interested in having their leader back instead. There is, after all, only room for one in this deal. Congratulations on completing your trial. I trust you understand your situation, Rutger Clausel.
Yeah, let me see if I got this straight. I get to pilot Zector, one of the fragments of the Great Power. Which means, somehow or another, I ended up being the chosen Sam. But not by old Palatinate over there, per se. You set me up, didn't you?
Oh, and what makes you say that?
Don't play dumb. I know you've been given weapons to both us and the Red Constellation. Wouldn't be any of my business ordinarily, but when I fought Baldur, I realized something strange was going on. We duked it out for 3 days and 3 nights straight. Guys gotta wonder how that's even possible. And on top of that, this big thing just happened to be sleeping right next to where we died. I can't even remember why we chose that place for our final showdown. But it's obvious to me now. You've been the one pulling the strings behind our backs this whole time.
Relinquish it to me. It belongs to me. Your soul. Your entire being.
You never do tire of this, do you? You are the embodiment of delusion. Repulsive. Without a single shred of dignity. Unlike Valimar.
Compared to me, the Ashen Knight is nothing more than scrap metal. Accept it! You, with the heart of a lion, deserve better. You alone deserve to pilot me.
Dreykos?
Damn. The Argent One comes. But it matters not. You shall never escape my grasp. No matter where you flee, your weary soul will never find refuge.
Dreykos, what was that just now?
It's been an age and a half, Leanne. You haven't changed at all from when I last saw you. No, if anything, you're more beautiful than ever.
Your flattery won't work on me. I assume you heard what became of me from Rose?
Indeed. She told me of your revival and how you'd left Erebonia in secret. What a heartless woman you are. We promised to grow old together. Yet you've left me here to grow old on my own.
Even so, my thoughts have always been with you. You and Evelyn's children have grown up splendidly, Your bloodline will surely be blessed with many descendants. I regret that I could not have given you the same. Nevertheless, I am truly happy for you.
Leanne.
Now please, tell me, what was that earlier? That horrible darkness hanging over you. How long has it been haunting you? And why?
My name is Georg. I never had a surname, but the chief told me to pick one, so I took out the G from Gnome and went with that. The idea of having GG as my initial sounded silly to me. Repetitive. That's really all there is to it. When I left the workshop, my real memories were replaced with fake ones. Not that it was so bad. It was as if I'd become a character in a story. I played my role, going to school, making friends, unaware that I'd been regularly reporting back to the workshop the entire time. They'd used the Faceless's hypnosis techniques on me, having stolen them from Ouroboros. But honestly, it wasn't that bad, considering it was just a dream. Reviving Crow was simply a matter of efficiency, nothing more. The chief gave me an earful for it, but I knew Crow would be a suitable candidate for the rivalries. That's the only reason I did what I did. It's the same reason I didn't kill Angie. And the same reason I gave the Courageous a chance.
Now, now, there's a good boy.
He has a gentle look to him. Just like you. We should be glad he hasn't taken after me. Though I suppose if he had my rugged features, he'd have no end of admirers.
I'm sure. Besides, you resemble your father too, don't you? Though I might start to worry if you turn out half as oblivious as him.
Hmm? How do you mean?
You see? But in a way, that's just what I love about your father. Take care, dear. Best of luck with tomorrow's mission.
I'll be off, then. I love you, Kasha. And you as well, Rin.
It's been 180 years since his passing, and only 30 since his soul found its way back to this world. A wonderful wife and a healthy child. It seems there's no need for me to be concerned. But I fear the darkness still hangs over him. Perhaps it's time I reconsider that invitation.
What? Again? Honestly, you and your research projects. Well, whatever it's about this time, I'm sure you'll make it a success. Like always. Just try and make it back for the weekend, all right? My father would love to spend some time with you. As would Elisa.
I'll see what I can do. I love you, Irina. Oh boy. What in Adios's name am I doing? Spending my days designing weapons instead of spending time with my wife and daughter? Not that these recent headaches are helping, or these sudden drowsy spells. They couldn't find anything wrong with me at the clinic, though. The Panzer Soldat. With any luck, it'll revolutionize the industry as we know it. But will it be good enough for the professor to approve as my final thesis? Wait. My final thesis? Where did that thought even come from? It's almost as though... Am I trying to leave this place?
Yes, you are. Open your eyes, Franz Lumen. I have already claimed the king. All that remains is his steward. Accept your fate.
Huh?
Mr. Franz Reinfurt? Pardon my intrusion. I am one of the enforcers of Ouroboros, number 9, the Severing Eclipse. I've come to retrieve the research reports, as per your agreement with Professor Novartis. You are Mr. Reinfurt, correct? An affiliate of the 13 Factories?
Though that is indeed my name, it is not who I truly am. Franz Reinfurt was nothing more than a temporary alias. It is nothing compared to my true self. A name passed down for centuries from one servant of the Great One to another.
I beg your pardon.
I suppose I should cast my alias aside now. You couldn't have arrived at a better time. I regret to inform you that I will not be relinquishing my research. Try and obtain it by force if you like, but be warned, it won't end well for you.
Looking back, I've experienced more than my fair share of misfortune. My parents were wealthy landowners in the north, but an avalanche claimed them while I was still young. By some stroke of fate, I was taken in by the Baron of Ymir and sent to Thor's Military Academy. As the years went by, my career progressed well, granting me many close friends along the way. And then, well into my 30s, I met her, the woman who would become my wife. Oh, I experienced my fair share of teasing, but in spite of that, our union was blessed. It was around that time, however, that I started hearing the voice.
Relinquish it to me. It belongs to me. Your soul, your entire being. Yes.
Unable to seek anyone's counsel, I tried to seal it deep within my heart. By the time we'd married and our son was born, the voice had faded into only the faintest of thoughts. But no sooner could I breathe a sigh of relief had it returned. At the very worst point of my wretched life.
Thank the goddess. You're okay. Please, Killian, I beg of you. Save our child.
No! Why? Damn you, Arendelle! What did Kasha and my son ever do to you? I'm your enemy! I'm the one you want! Hadios, please! Someone answer me! Goddess or fiend, I don't care! I'll do anything. Take me instead if you must. Just please! Spare our son's life!
Oh, how long I've waited to hear those words. Waited and waited, Thrykles, for 200 long years. This time, you will be my awakener, not the Ashen Knight's. Agree, and I will deliver your son from death.
It was you. You're the one who did this. All of it. But I don't care anymore. Take my body. Take my soul. Do what you will. So long as you save my son, it doesn't matter what happens to me. Ebonite, Ishmelga!
There it is, then. The whole truth.
So the duel the boss died in was rigged from the start.
By Black Alberic. But even he was just a puppet.
George, too. Though his circumstances were a bit different.
Yeah. And what was that thing possessing Elisa's dad, anyway?
It looked like he was taken over by another persona. The Chief of the Gnomes.
The being that possessed him has achieved immortality through means different from mine. I suspect it lives on by becoming one with any descendant of the gnomes it deems worthy. Almost akin to a parasite of sorts.
Father.
We also learned the truth about Arian Road, or Leanne Sandlot as she was once known. She spent 250 years watching over the Empire, as well as the man she loved most.
A saint in the truest sense of the word.
But that means the guy she spent all that time watching over is...
I admit, I always did have my suspicions. Why, for instance, did Emperor Eugent go to such lengths to support the Chancellor?
You're right. It all makes sense now. His Majesty had the entire truth in his hands this whole time. The Black Records.
He knew that the Lionheart Emperor, founder of Thors, father of the Renaissance, and victor in the War of the Lions 250 years back, had been reborn as Gilliath Osborne, the Blood and Iron Chancellor.
I never imagined reincarnation would be possible.
Paranormal bullcrap. Except it's for real this time, isn't it?
Of all the things for the visions to show us.
Those witless fools! Why didn't Leanne and Dreykles come to me? Did you not say we were friends? Was it all just a lie?
No. I am the one at fault. How could I have been so blind for centuries?
Grandmother... Rose.
Roselia, what can you tell us about this Ishmelga?
The Ebon Knight.
All signs point to him being the one behind all this, don't they?
It radiates an aura unlike any other divine knight we've encountered.
I do not know. This particular divine knight has remained mostly hidden for over 1,000 years. It was absent for both the War of the Lions 250 years ago, and the Dark Dragon's appearance 900 years ago. However...
It may have been the one behind them. Or perhaps, the one behind every tragic event in Erebonia's dark history.
No way. Valimar, Ordine, and all the other divine knights we've seen thus far have each had their own conscious mind. What if that mind were to become warped by malice, amassing it as a kind of power?
The gnomes and the Hexen clan have been at odds from the very start. Even still, we managed to reach a compromise 1,200 years ago. We stood side by side as we sealed off the Great One. We worked arm in arm to help found the Empire. But 800 years ago, after the reclamation of the capital, the gnomes suddenly broke off all contact with us.
And the one behind all of that was the Ebon Knight. It must have taken over the gnomes and made them into its followers. Well, that's the nice way of putting it, I guess. In reality, they're nothing more than its brainwashed minions.
And so they got involved with all sorts of shady stuff, including the boss's death. Moving their evil plans forward the whole time.
Yeah. Even now. That's the curse that Albrecht was talking about.
But what's its end goal? Bringing back the Great One? Or is it trying to win the rivalry of the Seven to become the Great One itself?
Is that what the OZ units were created for? What I was created for?
what Milliam gave her life for?
Just the thought of it makes me sick.
We can't let this stand.
Brain?
That thing is the reason for all this suffering. Not only in Erebonia, but in every country surrounding it. Crow, the Lance Maiden, and the Jaeger King were all made into immortals and forced into its game. It took Milliam's life, and the lives of so many others. Major Lecter's father, Major Claire's family, and others still, innocent people, all made into its victims. Elisa's father, George, my mother, even Chancellor Osborne himself.
Rain, keep it together! At this rate, the curse will take hold of you. It seems the truth was too much for him to handle.
Damn it! You gotta get it under control.
Calm yourself, my awakener.
Thalamor?
Oh, what is this? It feels so soothing. Where are we? Is this the phase space where Divine Knights and Awakeners make their contracts?
Nah. I get the feeling we're somewhere else entirely.
Thalamor, you can speak again? This is different from when we spoke back in the workshop, isn't it?
Correct. It seems the curse has temporarily loosened its grip on me. My means of expression remain limited, however. Perhaps I will recover the ability to speak in the real world at some point.
I hope so.
Thank the goddess.
Hear my words, Awakener and secondary contractors. The Ebon Knight is not the only one to blame for all the tragedies you named. Mankind's weakness contributed to bringing them about. If you fail to understand this, you have no hope of prevailing in the rivalries ahead. Even with the sword.
The sword? Can't be.
All right, it worked.
Milliam.
Milliam. Hey guys, did you miss me? I've been watching over you guys the whole time. Every time you got in a pickle, and every time you whooped your way right out of it. Guess I should say sorry, though, for not being strong enough. I wanted to be able to say, I saved the day, that I helped protect everyone. But I never thought I'd cause you guys all this grief instead.
Milliam!
You don't have to apologize.
Not in the slightest. You did more for us than we ever could have asked.
I'm guessing the two of you appeared to tell us something important. Am I right?
Yeah. Being stuck like this helped us finally figure a few things out. First off, you were right about the rivalries being struggles for power between the Divine Knights. Crow's an immortal, so he should have totally vanished from our world after he was defeated. But it seems like you guys figured it out. Making him your kin like that bought him some more time. Though, when it comes to the end of the Great Twilight, I probably don't even need to say it.
That's me, living with a death sentence over my head. Crow!
There is one more thing to mention regarding the Ebon Knight. His power is immense, beyond the reach or understanding of this realm. He could defeat every one of us. However, this would not make him whole again. He requires a worthy opponent. As such, I expect the following will occur. The Ebon Knight will wait until one knight has absorbed the power of the other five in order to have his worthy opponent. However, because this opponent has such power, it is at this point Ishmelga could potentially be defeated.
The Jaeger King's Palatinate Knight, the Steel Maiden's Argent Knight, the Prince's Vermilion Knight, Rufus's Auric Knight, and Reen's Ashen Knight, partnered with Crow's Azure Knight. It'll be one of them who'll be going toe-to-toe with the Ebon Knight.
How battered, Reen? Looks like we don't have much of a choice.
Your rivalry at the Soul Shrine was only a preview of what's to come.
Maybe we can convince the boss to join us, just like Crow.
Perhaps. And from what we saw in those visions, there could certainly remain a chance to recruit the Steel Maiden to our side as well.
That's right. They, of all people, should understand what it is we're fighting for.
We can make it work. I'm sure of it.
Ain't gonna be easy, but at least now we finally got some light at the end of this tunnel.
Maybe so. But I somehow doubt Rufus or the Prince will be half as eager to team up with us.
So long as Valimar can win the rivalries and absorb the power of their knights, it shouldn't pose too much of a problem.
With more allies and more power, we might actually have a shot against Chancellor Osborne.
Our odds may be slim, but this is our best chance to defeat Ishmelga for good.
I've made my decision, Valimar. Not as the sacrifice, and not as an ogre, but as myself. We're going to see these rivalries through to the very end, with you and Milium at our side.
Well said, my Awakener.
That's what I like to hear! I'll be right there with you all the way!
Milium! Stop! Don't go!
Please, wait! There's still so much I have to say!
Come on, guys! You don't have to worry! Even if you can't see me, I'm always with you! Remember, we're all a team! No matter what happens!
That wasn't just a dream, was it?
No, it wasn't.
Now I see. She was never gone. She's been here all along.
My big sister. I'm so glad.
She's come such a long way. I can hardly believe it.
What exactly was that, Grandmother?
A liminal space between dreams and reality, bestowed unto you by the spectral moon mirror. Something similar happened back when I inherited my predecessor's responsibilities. The mirror has granted us more than expected. All those centuries of watching over it were well worth it.
Yeah, they really were.
Roselia, and Emma, and Celine as well. Thank you for everything.
You could pass that on to Vita and the Rakshasa, too. Props for all the help.
Valimar has fallen silent once more, and it's unlikely Milium will be able to speak to us like that again. Yet, their souls are still with us, always. Of that, we can be certain.
Indeed. Now that we're all together again, there can be no more room for doubt in our path as Class 7.
And as members of the Radiant Wings.
Probably would have been screwed without you witches helping out, though. Guess that's worth a thanks or two.
Definitely. I think I'm finally ready to face my father and Sharon again.
Yeah, we owe you guys. Big time.
You guys. You're making way too big a deal over it. I didn't do anything. But I guess I'm glad things worked out.
Ah, it feels as though several centuries of weight has been lifted from my shoulders. As for the new facts that were revealed to us, I will let Vita and Thomas Lysander know what they should.
That'd be a great help. Thank you.
I'm just happy I was able to carry out my duty as a wandering witch. But I couldn't have done it if our family hadn't worked so hard to protect this sacred place. So thank you, Grandmother, for guiding our clan for so many years. And more than anything, for making me the person I am today.
Just where is all this coming from? What do you think you're doing? Are you trying to bring your poor granny to tears? This old heart of mine can only take so many surprises.
My word.
It would seem our little trip can be counted as a success.
We should bring the good news back to His Highness and the others.
Right. Best not to keep them waiting any longer. Let's be off. To the Courageous Two.
Sorry to break it to you. This place is a total bust.
Hey there. Good to see you, Schwarzer. Real shame you guys came all this way for nothing, though. Go ahead, take a gander. That's right. What we got here is the Draco Shrine, one of the sites for the rivalries. But the little subspace inside it got transported away just yesterday. I got the word from Albrecht and came to see it for myself. Truth be told, I didn't think they could just up and move the whole damn place either. Figured I'd come and check just in case. But sure enough.
Good. Looks like it worked.
We meet again, everyone.
Far sooner than expected, too.
I, the Severing Eclipse, am assisting the Reinford Company in their experiments on the Society's behalf. It is only a temporary arrangement, I assure you. That's exactly right. Our client sent us a last-minute request to build a magic barrier generator. We incorporated some technology from the Society in our design as well, courtesy of Miss Croyce.
Integrating magic and science together was bothersome, to say the least, if ultimately fruitful.
Ulbricht doesn't sound too wild about getting the rivalries going just yet. So, looks like I'll just be warming the bench till D-Day shows up. But I'm always up for throwing down ahead of time. All you gotta do is get past the barrier. Good luck.
You're welcome to try and infiltrate our ship, if you so wish. But you should be aware, we have defense systems in place to address any wrongful entries. If you attempt to enter, you had best tread lightly, lest you find yourselves eclipsed.
My combat shell and I will be ready to face you as well. I'll say it again, don't expect any mercy from me.
As for me, I will be merely watching from the sidelines. Let's hope the final Keep trial wasn't all you're capable of. I shall be looking forward to seeing how far beyond it you